Yes, thank
he
you.
Didn't molest you too much. That's one. Ooh. Ooh. We'll have a look at the side of your head in a minute when we've got a camera that can take the shock of seeing that bruise. It's amazing. But we've got the top 10 board. Would you like to read down the board? And you've got to try really hard, because we had Billy Connolly do it, and he took about half an hour. Dame Edna Everidge took about 15 minutes. Last week, Mr. Edward Heath, former Prime Minister, did it quite quickly. See how well you can do.
Shall I go from 1 to 10?
That's it. Start at the top and go down.
Well, first we've got Jason Walsh, and he's offering a Skeletrix 200 with lots of accessories and a treasure of the Faro game. And he wants a radio cassette recorder, please. Number two is Michael Tatterton, and he's offering a violin with two bows and a box, three-quarter size. And he wants any electronic game, please. Third we have Robert Widrington, and he's offering disco roller skates, size 7, and he wants a six-string classical guitar.
Please.
Yeah, mustn't forget the please. Number four, we have Martin Davies, and he's offering a TV entertainment centre and 3 cartridges. Sounds a bit extravagant. And he wants a large Skeletrix with accessories. Oh, he wants a radio cassette recorder. Right, number five, Paula Topping. She's offering a hairdryer and styling brush, and she wants a birdhouse or birdcage stand.
Please.
Number six, Sarah Gilchrist is offering a Lego set, and she wants anything to do with Adam and the Ants. Oh, preferably Adam in person. Please. Number seven, we have Neil Smith, and he's offering a Galaxy Invaders and Rubik Hexagon, and he wants an Atari cartridge, preferably Asteroids. Right, please. Number eight, we have Mark Spurge. It's quite a good name. Well, Spurgey wants an action man with tank and accessories, and he's offering a fishing rod and accessories for this action man.
Okay. Are you ready for this?
Number nine is Wai San Chun, I think. And I don't know if that's a boy or a girl.
I thought it was a Scottish name.
Well, this person would... is offering a digital watch and wants a World Cup edition of Subutio.
I think we can say it's a fella then.
And number 10 is Sarah Stoner.
What's funny about that?
It's a very in joke.
Tony?
John? Titch. Why you got gloves on?
Keep my hands warm.
Good thinking.
And Jim?
Yeah. And do you all come from the same part of Scotland?
Yeah, what? Glasgow.
Glasgow. Which part of Glasgow?
South side.
The south side. Which is where?
The north side.
To the north side?
Yeah.
Pick up a phone. I can see you're going to be trouble. We ought to have somebody on the line, even though my little machine down here doesn't say anybody's there. It's Louise Toad. Hello, Louise. I wish you'd have a phone. All right, you'll just have to listen.
Yes.
All right, Louise.
Hello.
Hi. What's your question for Altered Images?
I'd like to ask Claire.
Yes, you're through to Claire.
Surprise.
You want to speak to the one star in the group, yes?
I'd like to ask Claire, does she have a set dance routine?
Do I have a set?
Or does she make it up as she goes along?
Oh, it just comes naturally. I just make it up as I go along.
Sits up all week.
No, actually, our manager, Jerry's also our choreographer.
Choreographer?
Yes.
Scottish for dance.
A choreographer, that's Scottish for dance teacher.
Yeah.
And he designed your makeup and clothes.
I beg your pardon, sorry?
And who designed your makeup and clothes?
Oh, who designs my makeup and clothes?
Yeah.
Titch does that. Titch is in the clothes department, and Tony in the end does my makeup.
Is he also in charge of haircuts as well?
No, that's Jim.
Yeah. But you're very straight. I mean, you look like you've just come out of a bank.
Yes. Same bank as Cheesy, but road manager came.
I mean, you're smart. My mum would like you. I mean, she won't object.
I'm for the models markets, you know.
My mum objects to me being seen with people like you.
Yeah, me. I'm being victimised.
It's okay, and you're all right. You look reasonably educated, but as for the other two. Anyway, thank you very much. Do you want to ask anything else?
No, thanks, but you spelt my name wrong.
Oh, dear. Can I just apologise, because we haven't got time to redo it?
Yeah, it's Louise.
I'm very sorry.
Two.
Pardon?
It's Louise 2. T-double-O-L-E.
Oh, I see. Sorry about that. Not what
Louise
we put.
Louise 2?
Yeah. 2. Oh.
Gavin, hi.
Hello. Can I speak to Claire, please?
Yes, you're through.
Hello, Claire.
Hello, Gavin.
Where did you get your idea for name altered images?
Where did I get my idea to make
altered
images?
Yes, well.
Well, I'd been planning it for quite a long while, and then I met these four, and I felt sorry for them.
I can remember that we met her.
Oh, we were her.
No, you've asked the wrong person. I'm afraid this.
All right, who's going to answer that then?
Isn't mine at all.
Johnny. I was a manager, Jerry. He wrote something on a board and we thought it would be a good name for a band. So we just chose it.
He just wrote altered images?
Yeah. We couldn't find a name, so we just said, oh, what about for a name? He wrote altered images up on the board.
What's the point?
It was a good name for a band.
Yeah. Well, that's how it came about. Thanks very much for your question, Gavin.
Bye-bye, Gavin.
Bye. Alison Simmons.
Hello.
Hello, Alison. What's your question for altered images?
I'd like to ask Claire, what was her favourite subject at school?
What was my favourite subject at school?
Dancing.
My favourite subject, that's quite hard. I liked everything, actually.
Oh.
I was a real all-rounder at school.
Did you really?
She was never there.
No, my favourite subject at school was probably music.
Thank you for calling. I'm not sure you got a very serious answer, but thanks a lot for calling. We'll try and take some more calls after we've had the news, and you brought a swap along, which we're doing just for a little while. How long have you been together, actually?
2 years.
3 years,
dude.
2 years.
This is
about 3 years.
We're going on to 5 years.
Oh, good. Anyway, more calls in a little while, but 12 o'clock, it's time for John with his midday news. John, as promised earlier, he'll be back with the midnight bulletin in 12 hours' time. I'm not going to let him forget that. Right, pick up the phones again. Sorry, once again, you don't get a phone. Why not? You give him a phone.
Oh,
just sort of hum or something. Who's on the line? I can see theme music by B.A. Robertson, but nothing else. Who we got? Louise. Hello, Louise.
Hello, Noel.
Hello, Louise. You're through to altered images and Claire.
Can I speak to Claire, please?
Yes, certainly.
Hello, Claire.
Hello.
And where do you get all your energy from?
Where do I get all my energy from? Oh, well, I have my porridge every morning, and I think that helps.
It doesn't get up.
And because usually I lie in my bed most of the time, apart from when I'm on television, so, you know.
Get up an hour
I've got a bit of energy to spare.
Back to bed after this.
I don't know where I got it from. My mother, I think.
There you go, Louise. Anything else you want to ask?
That's all right, thank you.
All right, thank you very much.
Bye.
Thank
Bye,
you.
Louise.
Can we go through the swap now? What have you brought along? You can put the phone down.
Oh, yeah. I was enjoying it.
Yes. Well, it was nice hearing Louise's call. Now, come on, what are you offering?
Got some records that we couldn't sell. records and some posters and some prints of our artwork.
Some very valuable prints. It's not on sale at all.
Who does do the artwork?
A friend from Glasgow called David Band.
Hmm. It's a real resident inside there.
David? There you go. Righty ho. And an LP.
Ooh.
The famous gloves and ribbon.
The ribbon.
Yeah. Titches.
This is presumably the reason why you banged your head the other day.
Yes, I couldn't see that.
You've even got blood on it.
You've got lipstick.
Blood.
Is it really,
blood?
Can we see? Can we Tyson, please, on forehead? Look at the state of that.
That's all makeup. That's a makeup job.
That really is a most impressive bruise. Really good. Anyway, you are feeling all right now?
Oh, yes, I'm fine, thank
Jolly
you.
Good.
Just didn't hit hard enough.
So what we need is a question, really, from... are you ready with it?
Right, this is...
Don't get it wrong now.
Right, I won't. This is to confuse all the English people. Right,
OK.
This is, what group are Scotland in the World Cup and...
Don't put him off.
How many teams are in the group? And happy birthday, Janice.
Oh, yeah.
Happy birthday, she's 21.
I thought you were going to say name the teams that were in the group.
What did I say there?
How many?
Oh, yeah, name the teams.
That's easy, how many? Well, right, OK, so it's a footy question. You don't mind me recapping, just in case you confuse somebody.
Nobody understands.
How many football teams? No, what was it? World Cup soccer, Scotland. Want to know the other teams in their group, and which group is it?
So a Scots person should win.
Right, okie doke. Answer on a postcard, please. The Swap Shop, BBC TV, London, W12, HQT. Thank you, got the postcode right. Yeah. So, seeing she's been answering all the questions, let me ask you, what have you got plans for? We heard the new song.
Yeah, we're doing an album just now.
doing an LP.
Martin Russian.
What sort of things? I don't want to look at him. What sort of things are on the LP?
Songs.
Who writes the songs?
The whole band.
Claire does it all for us.
Yeah. And cheesy.
Do you really? You write some of the things, too?
Oh, yes.
She writes them all.
Yeah, just... I write everything.
Who wrote I Could Be Happy?
Claire.
Did you really? Gosh,
even
I am
bells,
impressed.
Even their bells.
She did the drums
background.
As well.
Yeah.
I'm just here for the scruff of me.
All right, well, thanks very much indeed for coming along. Yeah. And I hope the bruise improves fairly soon. Here's a chance to see Claire's composition, I Could Be Happy, Altered Images. Images ago.
Girl Claire Grogan and Altered Images.